Hari Om, welcome to this Ola 15 class on Atharva Veda. So let me start with a mantra from Atharva Veda, 3rd Kanda, 12th Sukta, the 2nd mantra. This is regarding the Shala Nirmana. Okay, so the builder, the Yajamana, asked the construction, the building. Ihaiva Dhruva Pratitishtha Shale. Ihaiva Dhruva Pratitishtha Shale. Ashwavati, Gomati, Sundrutavati. Urjasvati, Gritavati, Payasvati, Uchrayasva, Mahate Saubhagaya. O building, O Shala, you please be stabilized here. You stay here forever, full of horses, Ashwavati, Gomati, full of kine, the cattle, Sundratavati, all the pleasantries, then Gritavati, with nourishment, Urjasvati, with urja, tejas, you know, the vigor, the bala, and payasvati, plenty of milk, and uchrayasva mahate saubhagaya, please rise up for greater fortune. This is one of the Shantika Paushtika mantras, by the way. So we'll have today a brief introduction and some of the mantras, the types of mantras in Atharva Veda, the 4th in the list of the Vedic literature. We have already seen Rigveda, Yajurveda, Samaveda. So now comes the 4th one, the Atharva Veda. So this Atharva Veda was given by Veda Vyasa to Sumantu. Now just to recapitulate, Rigveda was given to Paila. Yajurveda was given to Vaishampayana. Then Samaveda was given to Jaimini. And Atharva Veda Vyasa gave to his Shishya called Sumantu. There are 20 sections. In the Rigveda, there were 10 sections, each section called Mandala. Here, 20 sections, each section is called Kanda. Okay? So there are 20 Kandas, 730 hymns. In Rigveda, there were 1058. Here, there are 730 suktas and almost 6000 or some plus or minus mantras. In Rigveda, the mantra is called Rich. In the Atharva Veda, the mantra is called Mantra. It is called mantra. Okay. There are so many various names of Atharva Veda, like Atharvangirasa, Bhrugvangirasa, Bhaishajya Veda, Kshatra Veda, Brahma Veda, Yatu Veda. You know, so many different names are there. So Bhaishajya Veda, because it deals with Bhaishajya, that is Aushadha. Okay. So it's a medicinal Veda. And therefore it is called Subhaishajya or Bhaishajya Veda. It is called Kshatra Veda. Kshatra stands for martial valor of the king. So all the kingly things, the Rajanya Karma, the Rajanya Suktas are mentioned here. And therefore it is called Kshatra Veda. We'll deal with one each type, you know, later in some slides. So Raja Karmani would also include Abhichara in that. And even Kautilya in his Arthashastra refers to Abhichara Karma, some sort of sorcery or black magic for the protection of the king and for the annihilation of his enemies. Okay. So we'll see briefly what these Rajanya Karmas are. Then there are other names, as I said, Yatu Veda. Yatu, like in Hindi and Marathi, we call Jadu. Yatu is Jadu. Okay. Magic. So this is magic. There are magical incantations. You just abracadabra, you know, like that. So it is Yatu Veda. Then it is Brahma Veda, and Brahma doesn't refer to the Upanishadic Brahma, which is Ekameva Advitiyam Brahma. Brahma here denotes an incantation, a spell, a charm, a mantra, okay, a curative mantra. So this is something when you are applying some medicine on the wounds of a person, you simultaneously articulate and recite some mantra that cures the person's wound. So it's a curative mantra. And then Brahma is also, you know, the priest of the Atharva Veda. We have seen the 4 priests. Rigveda has Hota, Yajurveda has Advaryu, Samaveda has Udgata, and Atharva Veda has Brahma. Okay? So this is Brahma Veda because of this. And almost I think 1/6 of Atharva Veda is comprised of Brahma. Okay? And Brahma also means the philosophical Brahma, because this is Adhyatma Veda as well. Now Sayana, when he started commenting on this, He has made it very clear in Atharva Bhashya Bhumika, Vyakhyaya Veda Tritayam, Amushmika Phalapradam. Amushmika, the otherworldly. Veda Tritayam, after finishing, after completing the commentary on the three Vedas, the reward of that is Amushmika Phala, that is a heavenly world that is given as a reward. After that he is starting this, Aihika Amushmika Phaladam Chaturtham Vyachikirishati. So after commenting on the three Vedas, now Sayana is commenting on the Chaturtha Veda, the fourth Veda, which gives you the reward, not only in the other world, that is the heavenly world, but here itself. Because this treats your ailments, this treats your diseases. So many other things which are very mundane, very practical, you know, and every day a person encounters these things. So, Aihika Amushmika Phaladam. We saw there were many branches of Rigveda, Yajurveda, Ekashatamadvaryavam, then Sahasravartma, Samavedaha, Navadha, Atharvanaha. Atharvana, that is Atharva Veda, is of nine types. There were nine recensions. Now we have only Shaunaka and Paippalada in Kashmir. It is written in Sharada script, you know, and that is being now recovered and recomposed, you know, after deciphering that. The other branches, there are two opinions, which are the nine recensions. So this is just for your knowledge sake. These are non-existent totally now, okay. Taudayana, Maudayana, Jalaja, Jalada, Brahma Veda, Devadarshana, Charana Vaidya. Charana Vaidya is a very, like, you know, what you can say, very unique sort of world. Charana, from chara, to move around, to go around, okay? Vaidya, he is a doctor. He goes around treating people, treating patients, but the patients don't have to go to the doctor. Here the doctor goes from place to place. Like you, even now we have some people whom we call in Marathi as Vaidu, not Vaidya, but he is Vaidu, or Jadi Bhuti Nikalke, you know, in Himachal also, there are so many such vanaspatis, and these Vaidus, wo raste pe ek dukaan laga dete hai apni, Himachal ki Jadi Bhutiyan hai karte, right? So these are called Charana Vaidyas. They move around treating the people. And then Paippalada, that is the ninth, and Paippalada was found in Kashmir, written in Sharada script. According to the other, the names vary, Danta, Pradanta, Snata, Sautra, Brahma, Davana. Other words are the same, Devadarshana and all that. So these are the two streams, you know, two different opinions of the nine recensions of Atharvaveda. We'll come to the etymology. Without etymology, we don't start any lecture, right? So let us do the etymology of Atharvangirasa and Rigvangirasa. These are the most often quoted names for this Chaturtha Veda. Though there are various names, as I said, Atharva Veda, Atharvana or Atharvangirasa, these are the popular names. So Atharvan, basically. Atharva and Angiras, there are two names here. One is Atharvan, the other is Angirasa. So Atharvan is derived from the word Athar or Atash, which means fire. Interestingly enough, in Avesta, Avestan language, in Zoroastrianism, we have Atharvan, not Atharvan, but Atharvan. So this Atash, you know, we have the word Atash Bhaji, that is fireworks. So Atash is fire. Athar is fire. So this is a fire priest. Basically, Atharvan means a fire priest. Then comes, and Atharva, there is another derivation. A is a negation. Like avidya, a vidya. Ajnana, a jnana. So a is a negation. So in Atharva also, a is a negation. Then what is the meaning of Tharva? Tharva himsayam. Tharva kautilye himsayam cha. So that Atharva means a kutila. Huh? Kutilatayaha abhavaha. Himsayaha abhavaha. So a kutila, a himsa. So the yajnas, the sacrifices which are prescribed in the Atharva Veda, they do not have any pashu himsa. That could be one meaning. Another meaning is these fire worshippers, called Atharvans, they are so gentle, so ruju, you know, in speech, in action, everything, that they are ahimsaka people. very mild, okay, and therefore Atharva. Another name is Angiras. Angiras could be derived from Angara. Angara is fire, embers, okay. Another word, another etymology would be Anga and Rasa. Angeshu, Sharira, Sharirasya Avayaveshu, Yaha Rasaha, Saha Angarasaha, okay. Saptadhatu Mayaha Angarasaha, Tam Adhikritya Yachikitsa, Saha Angirasi. So that is a body healing from using the liquids or the, you know, the secretions of body itself. That is another meaning of Angirasa. Popularly, it is stated that Atharvan is a milder aspect of Atharva Veda, and Angirasa is the hostile, the black magic part of the Atharva Veda. So these are the two, like, you know, dichotomy is seen there. So both these names are anyhow associated with fire rituals, Atharva as in Athar and Angara, you know, in Angirasa. So compare Atharvan in Avesta, and the Bhrugvangirasa is another name. In that also, Bhrugu is a dynasty, Bhrugu is a kula, right? Parashuram Bhargava, for example, we say. So Bhrugu is a kula. So Bhrugu and Angirasa, these two are the basic rishi dynasties who have composed the hymns of the Atharva Veda. So that's why it is called Bhrugvangirasa as well. This picture given by, the picture was, you know, like Angirasa Rishi and giving some knowledge to a king, a queen, Chola queen. So that's the picture from Google Swami. And then we come to whether the Vedas are three or four, because many times, you know, you get a reference to Vedatrayi, three Vedas. So Rug Yajus Sama. Even in the Atharva, in the Rugveda Purusha Sutta, we have the three references to three, Rug, Yajus, and Sama. No reference to Atharva. So whether initially there were only three Vedas. So Atharva Veda is blacklisted because of the black magic in it. And therefore it is not counted in the Vedic pantheon, Vedic literature as such. So that is one opinion. And especially many Western scholars, Western Indologists, they are of the opinion that maybe Atharva Veda is a later addition. But some feel that Atharva Veda and Rig Veda are the parallel traditions. Okay. Rig Veda is more of a class and Atharva Veda is more for the mass. So Rig Veda is a Veda for the classes and Atharva Veda is the Veda for the masses, for the common people. Because the mantras, etc. Even now in the villages you go, you know, the jadu tona vagara, jada chalta hai gaon mein, right? But not in the urbanized areas. So it is more, you know, closer to the common people as such. But on the other hand, you get in the Vedic literature itself, the reference to four Vedas. In the Upanishads, for example, you have Atharvanam Chaturtham, say Chandogya. Then Brihadaranyaka says Rugvedo, Yajurvedaha, Samavedo, Atharvangirasaha. So Atharvangirasa. Then Rugyajus Sama Atharvanaha Chatvaro Vedaha, very clearly in Narasimhatapaniya Upanishad. So we should not enter into this controversy whether there are only three Vedas or four Vedas. Atharva Veda has so much to study, the potential to be studied. So let us see something from the Atharva Veda. So there are many hymns. I said there are 750, 730 hymns. They are basically divided into four broad categories. They will have subcategories in them, okay? But four broad categories. Diseases and their cure, Vaishajya Sutta. Because the Atharva Veda, another name is Vaishajya Veda or Subheshajya. So everything related to cure of a disease. So what is the name of the disease? What are the symptoms of the disease? Then what are the precautions, you know, to prevent the disease? And if at all you are grabbed by the disease, how to cure it? So all the therapeutic use, the precautionary use, protective, everything is there. Okay, everything related to Vaishajya. So Vaishajya Sukta. And in that only, why, as is the principle of the Ayurveda, you know, Swasthasya Swasthya Rakshanam and Aturasya Roga Mokshanam. Both these are followed by Atharva Veda as well. And therefore many people feel, the tradition says that Ayurveda is the Upaveda of Rigveda, and Sthapatya or Arthashastra is the Upaveda of Atharvaveda. If you see the content as such, Ayurveda is very close to Atharvaveda because medicinal herb, the cure and everything, you know. So it's very close to Atharvaveda. So there are Dirghayushya Suktani, they are called Ayushyani. That's a subcategory of Bhaishajya. Then there is Abhichara Karma, that is Yatu Vidya. Yatu Veda it is called. So Abhichara Vidya, that's a sorcery, black magic and all that. And there are rites for fulfilling one's own desires, Vashikarana Mantra. Huh? And then there will be Sapatni Kshayana Mantra. Sapatni, co-wife. If a wife, you know, she wants to get rid of her co-wife because her husband is longing some other girl or some other woman, then there is some, you know, like mantra and something for Sapatni Kshayana. Okay. Such mantras are also there. They are all coming under Abhichara mantras. Then there is large class of Shantika Paushtika. The mantra which I recited at the beginning of the class was Shantika Paushtika. Okay. Because it's a constructive activity. Construction of a shala, and that shala, let it be, you know, equipped with and full of abundance, prosperity, fortune, you know. So Shantika Paushtika, in that we have the social significant mantras, suktas, therefore the Surya Vivaha Sukta, for example. In the Chaturdashakanda, there are only two suktas, both are Vivaha Suktas. And the Vivaha Parampara, the vidhis which are given there, the rituals which are mentioned, the similar rituals are there in the Griha Sutras, and even now we are practicing in modern day Indian Vivahas. Okay. So Garhastya Dharma, etc. Then building construction, as I said, Vastu Nirmana or Shala Nirmana. Then trade, commerce and agriculture, they are Krishi Sukta. That also will come under Shantika Paushtika because that is for the welfare of the society, you know. And then there is Rajanya Sukta. All the statecraft, warfare, then the war drums being beaten up, then the Raja being consecrated and coronated, his Abhisheka, then he choosing his own ministers, the chaplains, Purohita, you know, all that thing that comes under Rajanya Sutta. So Bhaishajya, Abhichara, Shantika Paushtika and Rajanya, these are the four broad categories. Now let us see every category, at least one or two examples. And then we get a fairly good idea of what Atharvaveda is. So let us go in the same sequence. So Bhaishajyani, Atharvaveda deals with all aspects of medical science, diseases, symptoms, etc., as I was telling you. And the therapy is so holistic. It's not as, you know, you go to a doctor, oh, I have some body ache and this and that. He will give you some painkiller and that's it. But Atharvaveda doesn't believe in that. It will have some gutika, some powder, some lepa, you know. If you have a headache, then shunti lepa. Even now we do that, shunti lepa. Shunti is dry ginger. Dry ginger, that powder you mix in water, you heat it and you put it on your head. It all gets shrinked. And when it's shrinked, you know, then you remove that. Oh, okay. That is like a plaster coming out of the wall. So that comes out. And your headache is gone. So the lepa. So the lepa is there. Then snana. Sometimes, you know, especially after the these like epidemics and like, you know, this jaundice and other diseases, we have that neem ka patta, the bitter neem tree. You take the leaves, you boil it in the water, and the same water you use for taking bath. So snana is there. And then Manidharana. Manidharana is Manibandha. This is Manibandha, the wrist portion. You tie some vanaspati, some mani. Mani is, you know, something, some tangible thing, okay? And that you tie in a thread, and you tie that thread along around your wrist. You can wear it in your neck. You can wear it around your vest. You can wear it on your arm. It is called Taviz. Talisman, okay, amulet in English. So Manidharana. So Aushadha Sevana, Lepana, Snana, Manidharana, four ways are there to treat. Okay, so this is a very holistic type of medication given in Atharvaveda. Why? Because Atharvaveda aims at Shatam Jeeva Sharado Vardhamanaha. Everybody should live minimum 100 years. Minimum. 120 is the lifespan. Okay. And Shatamana is the normal, you know, average life of a person. And how is the life? Dirghayuhu, it is Dirgha. It is Anamivaha, free from diseases. And Suvarchaha, full of glow. You must be glowing and not like this, you know, bedridden and all that. What is the use in living 100 years then, if you are bedridden? Okay. So Suvarchaha. And three things are emphasized in the Vedas. A Mamrihi, that is healthy life. Mamri is mru, to die. A Mamri, I mean, you can't be Amara, like gods. Jatasya hi dhruvo mrityuhu. One has to die one day or the other. But then as long as possible, at least for 100 years, one should be free from the fear of death. Amamrihi, amritaha, happy life, and atijivaha, long life. These are the three key words in Vaishajya and Arogya Suktas. And for that, lifestyle also is very, very important. How you can live for 100 years? So your lifestyle impacts your lifespan, right? So pranapanabhyam gupitaha shatam himaha. 100 winter seasons you can cross easily if gupitam, if you protect yourself. Prana and apana. Prana is inhaling, apana is exhaling. So pranapana, that is pranayama. So it is related to yoga in a way, right? So pranapanabhyam gupitaha shatam himaha. Then rajastamo ma upagaha. Do not succumb. Do not fall a prey to rajoguna and tamoguna. Always nurture and nourish the sattva guna in you so that you live longer and you live a healthy life full of contentment. So rajas is a sensuous lifestyle. You should not go for that, you know. Then tamas is absence of knowledge. That also you should not do, especially in this corona pandemic days. You know, when people are at home, they don't have anything to do. So they are like alasya tandra, alasya bhaya nidra, etc. That's not a good way. That's a tamo way, you know, tamo guna. So it should not be like that. Try to acquire knowledge. Kshanashaha kanashashchaiva vidyamartham cha sadayet. Kshanatyage kuto vidya, kanatyage kuto dhanam. So every moment you must be doing something positively to acquire that which you don't know. So tamo guna you can leave out. And nowadays I see on Facebook and other social media pictures of all, you know, delicacies and all things, cookery, you know, all good things they are preparing and they are eating. It's a sensuous way of life. It's a rajoguna. You know, it is only jivha laulya. It is only jivha laulya. So try to, I mean, it's once in a while, it's good. But every day pasta and what's that, paneer and other things, that is not good, you know. Noodles and this and that, though you may like it, or the fried things, vada pav and this and that, it's not good for your health. Then you can't aspire to live for 100 years then. If you adopt that lifestyle, then, and therefore, rajotama ma upagaha. So this is the, an armor of knowledge is necessary, which is called jnana varma. Varma is that which protects you, kavacha. So causes of death are also stated. There are so many diseases and so many causes of death. One is arati. Ra is to give. Ra sampradane. Ra is to give. One who is a non-giver. Non-giver of food, non-giver of money, non-giver of knowledge, vidya, whatever you have. If you don't share it with others, you are a sinner. You are a sinner. Okay? Na sa sakha yo na dadati sakhye, says Rigveda. One should not call a person a friend if he doesn't share what he has with his friends. Na sa sakha yo na dadati sakhye. Anyhow, so arati, then niruti is the long, wrong lifestyle. Raja and tamo yukta, wrong lifestyle. Then grahi, graha is to seize, to capture. So grahi are some chronic diseases, you know, like epilepsy and all. They seize you. So grahi. Then kravyada is bacteria which eats man's flesh, inner, like cancer thing also. They eat, you know, the cancer cells, they multiply very fast and they eat up from within, you know. So kravyada, pishacha, insects that drink man's blood, pishitam ashnati iti pishachaha. Then rakshaha, literary raksha is to protect, but raksha is like connotation is rakshasa, demonic, evil things, and therefore wicked people. And yakshman is a generic name for a disease. Later on it got equated with consumption, tuberculosis, and then we call it raja yakshma, yakshmanam raja, the biggest, the lord of the disease is tuberculosis. It kills hundreds and thousands of people every year, okay? So yakshman. Then there are, interestingly, so many names of diseases are given. We have, you know, we complain something about, sometimes about the headache, sometimes about the udarashula, then body ache and this ache and that ache. We have all these names. Sometimes our ear is pinching and we can't hear properly, it aches, you know, we do so many things and then we can't hear properly. Aches in every part of our body, okay? So Atharva Veda 9.8 mentions various types of aches or vedana or shula. Headache, pain in the internal part of the ears, which is called kankusha. Kankusha, the internal, the inner ear lobe. Then body ache, neuralgia or acute pain that radiates along a nerve, visalpaka it is called. Then pain that creeps through thighs and enters groins, it is called gavinike. In the groins there is a pain. Then autumnal fever, sharada takman. Takman is a fear. Takman has nothing to do with takra, okay? So sharada takman is the autumnal fever. And when we saw Rudra, I think if you remember, sharadivai bhuyishtham hanti. Sharad, autumn season, is the season when there are most deaths, because that comes in the sandhikala and people are not ready to take that, you know, it is the starting of the hima, the shishira ritu, right? Hemant and shishira. So sharada takman. Then jaundice, which is called hariman, and diarrhea, which is called apva, because up, diarrhea is dysentery, you know, liquid water is flowing out, okay? Then balasa, that is cough, sickening urine, amayat mutram, sometimes the urine stinks, it has a very foul smell, that is called amayat mutram. A pain in the belly, in the lungs, in the bladder, in the ribs, in the sides, crown of the head, joints, intestines, rectum, knees, not a single part is left out, okay? And this Atharva Veda 9.8, so those who want to really read in the original can go to Atharva Veda 9.8 and read for themselves, okay? So these are the various names. And then there are four types of aushadhis, the therapies, the therapeutic part of the Atharva Veda, the aushadha yojana. I told you there are like aushadha, aushadha sevana, snana, lepana and manidharana, but aushadhas are of what type? There are four types, very taxonomical, very analytical, you know. So, aushadhayaha prajayante yadatvam pranajinvasi atharvanihi. What are these aushadhi? Atharvana aushadhi, angirasi aushadhi, daivi aushadhi and manushi aushadhi, manushyajaha, four types. So, what are a manushyajaha? They are man-made. Man found some herbs which are, you know, like very useful. He found it by trial and error, by experimenting, and then he makes some syrups, kvatha, kashaya, or powders, you know, a gutika. So these are man-made. Whatever you get now, you know, in the Ayurvedic drugs, like the pharmaceutical companies, they are selling is like syrups, powders, gutika, etc. Then daivi is the adhi daivika and adhi bhautika type. So water therapy, then atapasevana, the sun therapy, these are like the daivi, you know, you for vitamin D deficiency, we have for the rickets and all that, there is atapa sevana which is prescribed even now, right? So daivi is like sun bath or water therapy and all that, wind therapy,
then there will be fragrance therapy, aroma therapy, so many things are there. Angirasi is the body secretions, anga rasa, so like saliva or urine used as medicine, and that is called Shivambu urine, it is Shivambu. And the late Prime Minister Morarji Desai, he used to practice Shivambu sevana, you know, swamutra sevana, to keep oneself fit, okay. And prana is also called rasa, so pranic healing, which is a very key word these days. There are so many classes going on, online also. So pranic healing, prana is inside our body. So pranic healing could be angirasi aushadhi. And then atharvana aushadha is like the mantras, the incantations, the, yeah. And this could be the occult practices also, commonly found even now in the villages. When there is a snake bite and all that, some mantrik is called, okay. And he will do something, but then there will be a mantra. And the poison goes down or gets vanished. So these are the things. Then Ayushyani. So Ayushyani, the Vedic seers aim to live long, very optimistic view. You know, Vedas never speak of leaving aside all your works, go to Himalayas and do tapas. They are very pravritti margi. Okay, they are very pravritti margi, very optimistic. And Shatam Jeeva Sharado Vardhamanaha, that's how we started. So long, healthy life, both physically and mentally, spiritually, emotionally, and all that are included in that. And therefore, the incantations are uttered. This is sort of a divine intervention in the cure of a person. And Manidharana is for long life. In Shakuntalam, for example, Manidharana, in Atharvaveda itself, I have a paper on Atharvaveda's Manidharana, maybe I'll share if the students are curious. So Manidharana for long life, and Shakuntala also has a reference that Bharata's mani falls down and Dushyanta touches it and nothing happens. Otherwise, you know, whosoever used to touch it, sarpo bhutva tam dashati, you know, that was the thing. But then Dushyanta was his father, and therefore it did not have any adverse effect on him. So te krinata jarasamayu rasmai shatamanyan parivrunaktu mrityun. May Agni, Surya and Ushas protect me and confer on me immortality. Now Te refers to, this is Atharvaveda 17.1, 30th mantra. Agni, Surya and Ushas, these three gods are invoked. And the Rishi says that may they protect me and confer upon me immortality. Abhichara karma, abhichara karmani, like after Bhaishajjani, we come to abhichara karmani. Jarana marana, vashikarana, uchchatana, sapatna kshayana. Sapatna is enemy, sapatni is co-wife, because she is treated as an enemy. So sorcery, black magic, all hostile things, you know, not very benign things, very malign, you know, those sort of things. And tying a mani to defeat the enemies. For example, there is a very nice sukta. This is Atharvaveda 129. Abhivarta mani. Abhivartaha abhibhavaha sapatnakshayano manihi. If the king wears that mani, his purohita of course would help him doing that. You know, the mani has to be dipped in a patram where there is milk and curd and madhu, honey. Then overnight you soak that mani, that thread, to which that money is tied, money is woven in that, and then next day with mantra you tie it on the manibandha of the king, and that will make him victorious, invincible. He can't be defeated by his enemies. On the other hand, he will be defeating all his enemies. Sapatna kshayano manihi. And the king says, Rashtraya mayam badhyatam sapatne bhyaha parabhuve. O priest, O brahmana, please tie this amulet to me. For what? Rashtraya. For the welfare of my nation, my country. And sapatna parabhuve. Sapatnebhya parabhuve. For the defeat of the enemies. So there are these magical charms on enemies and all that. Now there is sort of sympathetic magic also here. I mentioned to you that the disease jaundice is called Hariman. Now, even now, I have seen it, you know, just say 15-20 years back in Borivali. When there is a case of jaundice, You take the medicine, the allopathic medicine or whatever, but there are lot many Ayurvedic things are also going on, and lot many mantra things are also going on even now. Okay, and you go to mantrik and he will give you something to drink. He will make you sit on a chair, and below, you know, he will keep a vessel, a broad one, okay, and there is water in that. Your feet are submerged in that water, and after that mantra, the water turns yellow, as if the yellowness from your body has gone into the water, and your jaundice is gone, it's cured. In Atharva Veda, we have a reference that there is a mantra, and after reciting the mantra, the mantrika says, you know, that let your jaundice fly away along with the yellow canary, yellow bird, because this is yellow bird, and this is also called yellow disease. Jaundice is a yellow disease. So yellow going with yellow, this is called sympathetic magic. Okay, then in 513, in the fifth kanda, 13th mantra, against snake poison, this is a very interesting mantra, interesting sukta. There is a snake bite case, okay. Normally, in a snake bite case, what do people do now? First aid, they make him lie down, okay, lie down, not moving much. And if there is a wound, normally snake bites in the leg, okay, not here or here, okay. Because while you are walking in the jungle, it will bite your leg or foot, the toes. So you make him lie down, and on the leg, you tie some plaster, tourniquet. You tie it very tightly, so that poison doesn't go up in your body and doesn't get mixed with your body, okay. Then sometimes there is a little incision made, and that part of blood, you know, where the snake has bitten, that is removed, so that if there is some venom, some poison, that will be flushed, okay. So like that, this is the first aid even now. Atharvaveda speaks about all that, and along with that, there is a charm, because there is abhichara. This is a mantra Veda. There is abhichara. So what this priest will do, he will take a bunch of grass in his hand, he will burn it, okay. And suppose the man is lying down here, there is the sarpabila, okay, the mound in which there is a hole, and a sarpa stays there, the snake stays there. So he will burn that bunch of grass and throw it in that direction, and say this mantra, okay, ahe, O snake, mriyasva, die, ma jeevihi, don't live, ahe, mriyasva, ma jeevihi, pratyagabhetu tvavisham, you have bitten this person, let that venom, let that poison go back to you. So like that, there is a charm, it's a spell cast on the snake. Funny, right? It looks funny. So we have done with abhichara. Now let us do something with the shantika paushtika. Shantika paushtika, these are act of pacification, purification, then propitiation, expiation, prayaschitta karma, they also come in that, and anything which is of social significance, all that will come under shantika paushtika mantra. For example, I recited the mantra of Shala Nirmana, that comes under this. Griha Nirmana, Shala Nirmana, Vivaha Sukta, construction of a buildings. And in that very sukta which I recited, in that there is a reference that Purna Kumbham Abhara Nari. You know, when even now, when you enter a new house, what you do? You take a pitcher, a jar filled with water, a kalash. Kalash filled with water, and normally the lady of the house or a small girl, female gender, they take that kalash and enter first in the house. Even now that is practiced, right? So the practice goes back to thousands of years from Atharva Veda. So this is a woman or a girl is regarded as auspicious, and she is supposed to enter that house with a kalasha. Then there are agricultural activities, Krishi Suktas are there. And ploughing, sowing, harvesting, all these agricultural activities are described, okay. For example, I think there is one, no, I have quoted something different, but in the same sukta, there are like the suktas, there are the mantras like, oh, come all together, O farmers, come together. Sow the seeds. First plow the field. Sow the seeds. Wait for the rain. And when the crops come up, then this is the mantra. Nediyaha itsrinyaha pakvamayavan. Nediyaha itsrinyaha pakvam ayavan. Srini. Srini is a sickle with which you cut the crops. Srini. It's a sickle. So what the mantrakara says, the rishi says is, let that ripe corn, the harvested corn, come near the sickle. That means it's time to cut the crop and harvest it. So harvesting the thing. And interestingly, this Krishi Sukta will have Indra as the deity. We have seen Indra in the Rigvedic Indra. Indra is the god of Parjanya, the officiating god. And therefore he sends out rains. Unless there are rains, there will be no crops, no harvest. So Indra is the deity. And along with Indra, there is Sita as the deity. Now one may wonder why Sita comes here. This is not the Ramayana Vali Sita. This is not Sri Ramachandra's Sita, Janakanandini Sita. Sita is a furrow made by plowshare. When you are plowing the field, the mark which is made, created, that is called Sita. Okay? So Sita is also worshipped. And Sita Vandavahe, Vandamahe, O Sita, that is not that Janakanandini Sita, this Sita, Bhumi, okay, which is a ploughed land, field. Sita Vandamahe, Tva, we bow down to you, Arvachi Bhava, Subhage Bhava. Arvachi, you turn your head towards us, that means bless us. Bless us, okay? Arvachi Subhage Bhava for our fortune. Yathanaha Sumana Aso, Yathanaha Suphala Bhuvaha. You turn towards us in such a way that we become Sumana. If we get bumper harvest, we will be very happy and our mind will be at rest. Otherwise, we will be disturbed. So, Sumana, our mind will be peaceful, at rest, and Suphala, we will be having money out of that and we can live happily the whole year. Then there is a 14.1 is Vivaha Sukta. There are many, I mean this is a Surya Vivaha Sukta which comes in the Rigveda also in the 10th mandala. I think 1095 is a Rigveda number. In the Atharvaveda it is 14.1 and 14.2. Both are, there are only two suktas in the 14th kanda and both are Vivaha Suktas. Okay, and it's a very long sukta, like some 60-70 mantras are there in that. Very 63 I think. So many mantras are there. And so many rituals are described which are observed by us even now, even today. Right from, you know, like the muhurat, we seek a good day for a wedding. And there is a reference to that. There is a Panigrahana reference. There is a Dhruva Darshana reference. You know, Pariyankarohana reference. Then the Snana, Vadhu Snana is mentioned. So many details are there which are done even now, you know, in Indian weddings. So that also will come under Shantika Paushtika because it is a social institution. Marriage is a social institution. Again, there will be some rain, you know, that will also come under Shantika Paushtika. So Atharvaveda 4.15 is a very good hymn for rain and the description is so nice, you know. Let the clouds driven by wind, Vata Jutani, Vata Juta driven by the wind, let the clouds, Abhrani, gather together and pour down. They should rumble loudly like a bull. Maharshabhasya nadataha nabhasvataha. You know, Maha Vrishabha, like a mighty bull. Let them rumble, let them roar loudly and then apaha prithivim tarpayantu and let them shower in plenty so that the prithivi gets satiated. She gets, you know, contained it. So, and then there are philosophical hymns. I told you, it is called Brahma Veda also. And I think one sixth of the Atharvaveda comprises of the philosophical hymns. The best is the Skambha Sukta in the Atharvaveda. And there are many others also. And they speak of cosmology, of harmony and concord. Like we have Sangachadvam, Sambadadvam. Similarly, Sammanasya Suktas we find in the Atharva Veda as well. One such sukta is 330. Anuvrataha pituhu putraha mata abhavatu sammanaha. How a family life should be. I told you garhasthya. Garhasthya jivana forms the major part of Shantika Paushtika. And what is a healthy family or a very happy and contented family picture? Where the husband and wife are there and the children listen to their parents. Okay. So anuvrataha pituhu putraha matra bhavatu sammanaha. Their mind is, you know, in sync with their mother's mind and they follow what their father wants them to do. Jaya patye madhumatim vacha vadatu shantivam. And where the wife talks madhumati vach, not quarreling with her husband, very softly she speaks with her husband madhumati vach, with a very sweet sonorous sound, you know, jaya patye vacham vadatu shantivam. Such a house is a peaceful house. What a grand picture of a very healthy, and this is what we need in corona days. Otherwise everybody is at home and everybody is, you know, like haunts. So that should not happen. Anuvrataha pituhu putra. Very lofty message Atharva Veda has given here. Then we come to the last part of the last type of the hymn, which is called Rajanya Sukta. And there are variety of topics which are dealt with in this. For example, election of a king. How a king, a Raja, is elected. Then his consecration and coronation, his Abhisheka, Rajya Abhisheka, 3-4 is election, 5-8. There are so many hymns, so I could give you only numbers, one or two mantras I will quote here. Then restoration to power of an exiled king. Suppose for some reasons a king has been exiled, he has lost in the battle and therefore he has resorted to some forest. But then again he comes back, fights back, you know. Kickstarts and fights back, so he is enthroned again newly. So that sort of restoration of power. Then superiority over other kings, there are so many hymns like sovereignty of the king and prove himself superior to the other feudatory kings. Then acquisition of strength, that is varchas, raja varchas. Glorification of the purohita, it is not only the king, it is the purohita as well, because raja alone can't rule. He has to be aided, always assisted by his right hand is Purohita. So you see the best kings in the history, every king has had a best Purohita in the world. And therefore such a combination always turns victorious. And where there is a rift or a conflict between the Raja and the Purohita, they are doomed. Both of them, they get doomed. And the kingdom also gets doomed, okay? And therefore they have to work in sync. It's a teamwork. Idam Brahma, Idam Kshatra. Both have to work hand in hand. So the glorification and the chayana, the selection of the Purohita, the battle drums, the war chariots, so many things are there in the Rajanya Karma Suktas. Varshma kshatranam ayamastu rajendra shatrum randhaya sarvamasmai saunshitam me idam brahma saunshitam viryam balam saunshitam kshatram ajaramastu jishnuhu yasyaham purohitah. First mantra says that varshma kshatranam ayamastu rajendra. Kshatranam varshma. Varshma is the glory, the strength. Let the glory of all other kings take resort in you, O best of the kings, Rajendra. Okay? For what? Shatrum randhaya sarvamasmai. So that you will be able to vanquish all your enemies. The second mantra says, Samushitam me idam brahma. My brahma is sharpened. You know, like on a stone you sharpen the blade of a sword. Similarly, this Samushitam me brahma, my brahma, my brahma varchas, my Brahmanical luster is sharpened. My martial luster, Kshatra Teja, is also sharpened. And Jishnuhu, Yasyaham Purohitaha. If I am the Purohita, the king has to be victorious. Jishnuhu, yasya rajnyaha aya aham purohitaha. If I am the purohita of a particular king, that king has to be victorious. Such a confidence, you know, the purohita has, because that type of importance is given by the king also. Equal status is given by the king to him as well. So, let my mantra and my heroism be sharpened. Victorious be the authority of whom I am the priest. Okay. Now, in short, the literature of the Atharva Veda, the shakhas are Shaunaka and Paippalada, which are available. Others we saw, they are not available. They are almost extinct. Their Brahmana is only one Brahmana Grantha, Gopatha Brahmana. The Sutra Granthas are Vaitana Shrauta Sutra, Kaushika Sutra, Varaha Sutra, Vaikhanasa. These are all the Griha Sutras. Upanishads are Prashna, Mundaka, Mandukya. These are the three Upanishads. And the Upaveda is traditionally Sthapatya Veda or Arthashastra. But as I told you, it is more close to Ayurveda. So why not call Ayurveda as the Upaveda of Atharva Veda? Because there are many hymns and many like details of, you know, the Ayurvedic Upachara Paddhati, which tallies with the Atharva Veda Paddhati. Okay. So with this, I think I will end today's lecture. And interestingly, there are some comments in the comment box. And one person, after listening to the first question, first lecture, that person has commented that I am very impressed and I request you to take, and that person has given a long list of topics. It starts from Shaiva Darshana, Purna Prajna Darshana, Ramanuja Darshana, and then Banabhatta's Kadambari, Kiratarjuniya, these five I remember now. Abhijnana Shakuntalam. So there is Natya Shastra. Yeah, I remember Natya Shastra. So it's a long list. So I just want to convey to the questioner, I should say, or the inquisitive reader and listener, that I will be dealing after these Vedic portion, I will do the Vedangas first, and then I will be turning to the Darshanas. And in the Darshanas, Shankara Darshana, Ramanuja Darshana, Madhva Darshana, Vallabha Darshana, even if possible, Abhinava Gupta's Shaiva Darshana, I would try to cover. And thank you for your feedback, and keep commenting on the box, and keep writing to me or to our IT and media. And thank you for joining. And these classes will go on till you show your interest, till you are curious to attend. Otherwise, there is no end to knowledge. Sanskrit, I told you in the first lecture, it's such a vast treasure of knowledge. One janma is very, very insufficient. I quoted meghe maghe gatam vayaha. In the entire life, 90 years, Mallinatha says, I could study only Meghaduta and Maghakavya. Then what to talk about all this? But then we will try to cover as many things as possible with your support and assistance. Thank you. We'll end with a common prayer. Sarve bhavantu sukhinaha, sarve santu niramayaha, sarve bhadrani pashyantu, ma kashchid dukha bhag bhavet. Om asato ma sadgamaya, tamaso ma jyotirgamaya, mrityor ma amritangamaya. Om purnamadah purnamidam, Purnat Purnamudachate, Purnasya Purnamadaya, Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Harihi Om Shri Gurubhyo Namaha. Harihi Om. Dhanyavadaha.